So when comparing Hadoop and HBase, it's actually not quite fair comparing them because HBase is actually part of Hadoop ecosystem. HBase is actually sits on top of Hadoop, or speaking more precisely, it sits on top of HDFS, which is Hadoop Distributed File System. So HDFS is designed to be a very inexpensive at scale and a highly tolerant file store file system, very specialized file system. In order to make it inexpensive, scalable, performant, and highly available, there were certain compromises to that file system, which basically made all files in that file system read-only. The data cannot be updated in the files. There's a sort of single-threaded write operations, and etc. So it's designed to really be highly performant at scale when multiple processes ingest data at the same time, and multiple processes scanning massive amounts of data at a time. And HBase actually sits on top of this file system, on top of HDFS, in order to provide more like random access to data, random read and write access to data, and make this data at the same time a little bit more structured. It's sort of a key hybrid columnar store when you need to structure your data in a certain case. Now, obviously, when you have HBase, you naturally have Hadoop as well. Oftentimes, the data can be stored in HDFS directly as well as in HBase and can be used for different sort of patterns of access. When you need sort of accessing few records at a time, you can go into the HBase and look up by, let's say, by this key, for example, the whole row of columns. Or when you need to scan massive sets of data, it'll be more cost-effective and quicker to scan it directly off HDFS. So you could often see them living with each other in the same cluster. Sometimes if HBase is your backend for online system, whether it's your website or some other sort of real-time application, combining different workloads on a Hadoop cluster like HBase with MapReduce workload or HBase with like real-time query like Impala, It may impact sort of HBase consistent performance. So oftentimes people build, in this case, kind of dedicated HBase clusters, which is serving only HBase workloads. But a lot of the time, especially in more like a data hub, data lake deployment, you would see HBase deployed side by side with Hadoop, MapReduce, real-time queries, sort of analytical queries like Impala, search, and etc.